Hello, my friends, and welcome to another cool DaVinci Resolve tutorial. And today we're filming on Blackmagic Pocket 4K model, and I'm gonna show you what to do just in case you underexposed your shot. And it happens quite a lot in the industry. Sometimes you underexpose, or sometimes you forget to change exposure, for example, or you move from one location to another one, and just by whatever way you forgot to change your aperture or adjust for different lighting. So in this video, I'm gonna show you easy trick that costs you absolutely nothing that you can do in order to absolutely fix that. So let's get started. All right, so let's say a situation. You're filming dark at night and your footage looks dark. So you take it to the video editing application. In our case, it's DaVinci Resolve, and you have a lot of gray. If you're familiar with audio editing, you know that in audio editing and audio recording, there's a thing that's called room tone. Now, room tone can be used for various applications, and one of the applications can be to grab the signature of the room tone and later in post use it to remove unwanted noise, whether it's a refrigerator, a fan, an air conditioner, or whatever. Well, we can do exactly the same with the video, and I'm going to show you how to do this. So here I have a piece of paper, okay? Let's say that you're filming and you know that you don't have lighting, and in the future you may have problem with the noise. So what we can do, we can capture that room tone just with a simple piece of paper. Now, you can use technically for this anything, however, white piece of paper. Be sure that there is no texture on it, there is no writing on it, it's just a clean white piece of paper that you can use this thing to capture your noise signature and later completely get rid of it. So only thing you need to do, let's say you're filming in a dark environment, ask your talent, whatever the shot gonna be, to hold this paper for 1 second right in front of them. Make sure you focus on this paper, and then in the post, and I'm gonna show you in a second, you can completely get rid of the noise. So let's jump in DaVinci Resolve, and I'm gonna show you exactly how to do this. It's very easy and very effective method. All right, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and I have a couple clips for you. One is DNX HR and another one Blackmagic RAW. That way I kind of show you the concept in both clips. So here is very same from the introduction that you've seen. Here's gorgeous, beautiful me holding piece of paper. Okay, so let's say this shot right here. We have a nice clean texture. And if we zoom in, we can see that indeed this part right over here has a lot of noise. And it's very clean, it's a solid piece, and you can use technically whatever the hell you want. Piece of plastic, credit card if your card is, you know, solid without any texture on it, note cards, whatever you like. Okay, so let's say you finish color grading or color correcting, and now you got to get rid of this noise. So what we're going to do in the end of your color correction, and by the way, it depends, I made a video about it like a year and a half back where I was presenting whether you do noise reduction in the beginning or in the end. It actually depends. In our case, let's say, assuming we're doing in the end of the color grading process. So here we have it, and we're going to use Neat Video. It's fantastic plugin. I'm not being sponsored by it. Those guys have no idea I'm doing the video. It's just my personal favorite plugin I've been using for years, and it's really been saving my ass on commercials, feature films, you name it. This thing is really incredible. Anyways, so we're gonna drag this Neat Video on our last node, and let's do prepare noise profile. So what you have to do, very simple, select a square if we're not going to go too much into details. So let's see that this looks the most neutral to me, I'm guessing. Okay, and you can see the amount of noise in the little squares. Okay, and let's click Build Profile. If you want to do a little bit more advanced, go to Adjust and Review, and we can do it a little bit manually. I'm going to show you. So let's select High. Be careful, you really need to have a very powerful computer. Now, Temporal Noise. Let's click on it, and it's going to show us basically what we're looking for. So this is ideal. So we kind of have a little bit noise on the edges. Okay, so let's click Begin. And we can see that this is exactly what I have. Okay, so let's finish. Now, it's very important. Noise reduction amount. Okay, don't really mess with this. I don't recommend. But very important is local flicker. Okay, let's click Begin on that one. And if we're going to click on the question mark, it's basically going to show us identical situation here. And we can see that in this case, I probably should dial a little bit more. So something, probably something like that. So our value is going to be 9. So let's click Finish and let's click Apply. And here we have it. So you can see my beautiful ginger beard over here. And let's toggle before and after so we can really see how much damage does this plugin does. And we can see there is absolutely no damage. The amount of details remain identical after the noise reduction. So if we're going to look at the whole picture, look at that. It's very nice and clean. So let's check it out here, before and after. So this is really fantastic. The same thing let's do in the raw settings. So this was shot with ISO 200. Let's just probably do 1000. That's a huge jump, or we can say huge jump. And we can see that I'm focusing from one object to another one. But if we zoom in, we have a lot of noise in the blacks. And by the way, ideally, you probably should have a proper gray card. That would be ideal for capturing noise, or plastic little black card, but it doesn't really matter. Piece of paper on the budget works. So we're going to do similar thing here. We're going to do new note. We're going to go reduce noise. Click here. Let's do the profile. So let's select something over here. Oh, by the way, what am I doing wrong? Let's focus on the paper. That way we get as much information as possible to capture a clean profile. Okay, so something like that. Over here we can see all the little noise. Let's click Build Profile. Again, let's do quality higher because we want perfect frame. So let's begin here. That looks perfect. Local flicker, begin. We probably can dial a tiny bit more. So 6 in this case, let's click Apply. And here we have it. Let's zoom in the area where we had a lot of noise. So let's toggle before and after. So let me show you. That way you can see how big of a difference it makes before and after. And just like in very first case, the image remains absolutely clean. And like I said, this thing saved my ass millions of times in my whole filmmaking and colorist career. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Be sure to subscribe, click like, click notification button, and I'm gonna see you in the next video. Take care, my friends.